Hi, welcome to Tech Rudransi, and we are learning PHP, and in this part we will understand dompdf. Using this we can convert any HTML file to a PDF file, and we will generate invoice as a PDF format, and also we will see how we can export the data in an Excel format in a PHP using dompdf. So I want to show you a demo, and let's see how dompdf works. So let's see a quick demo and understand, and then we will write code. So let's see. So here is my HTML, and this data is coming from a database, and we have two files, download as a PDF and download as an Excel format. So when we click on a download as a PDF, so it automatically generate a text invoice.pdf, and this file is look like invoice. So we have done. And next thing we need to see download as an Excel format. And when we click, let's open this file in a Excel. So it will show the same data as we have seen in a PDF, right? So this thing we will do using a dompdf. This is the GitHub page, right? So dompdf and dompdf, right? I will give you a link. I will give you this link in a video description, so you can come here and get the benefit of this. So let's create a new project. I'm currently on a ST dog, and here I will create a project using NetBeans. So let's go to a file and create a PHP application and give the name of your PHP file, a PHP project. Just I'm giving a dompdf, and let's finish it. You can give your project name any, right? So let's remove the comments, and here we will write code of dompdf, right? So we need a composer. This is the composer. Let's click on composer and download. So this is a dependency manager. So let's download this exe file and install in your computer, and then we need to run this command. Just copy this command and go to your project, just dompdf, right? Hold the shift key, right click, and open command window it here, and paste that command, and let's enter. So it will take some time to download all the packages, right? So if you see generating auto load file, it means your package is automatically generated, and it means it's good for your project. It means it's working fine in your project, right? So next thing we need to write a code it here. So anchor tag, we need to two links. One is for download as a PDF and export as a in a Excel format. So let's download as a PDF file. So let's copy and br tag. Let's copy this link and make it one more. So let's paste it here and just replace it export as a Excel format. Export export export. I'm having lots of the spelling mistakes, so sorry for that. Right, export as Excel sheet. Right, so let's see and run this project. So we have two links: download as a PDF and export as Excel sheet. Right. So what next thing we need to do? Right. We need some code, right? So let's this is a GitHub page, and we need to include this vendor.autoload.php file. So we need two files. One is for pdf.php and one is for excel.php. Means this files, this is for Excel and PDF formats, right? So we need to create two files in our project. So new and text files, we need to pdf.php. This is one of the file. So using these files we will convert our PDF data, HTML to PDF, right? So let's put our PHP tag. So p question mark PHP, this is the opening tag of a PHP, and right, and one more file we need to create, excel.php, new and excel.php, excel.php. Right, so let's also drag and drop this file inside in a code editor, and this is the take of a PHP. Let's copy and paste. So same things, just name is different. So here is for PDF. So we need to use a PDF dompdf class sit here. So dompdf and for backward slash and dompdf. So this is the class which we have included, which we have import in our file. So we need to include autoload.php and autoload.php inside a vendor folder, right? Vendor directory. So this that is I want to show you vendor, and here is autoload.php, right? And next thing, we need to create a new variable. You can give it any, but I'm giving it HTML. This is HTML, and just put it single quotation, and here will be your HTML codes and HTML templates. I will show you in a minute. And so there's data in between here from a database and just dummy content and dummy HTML. ML and anything you can put it here in this variable. I will show you. Just you need to wait. So next thing, also we need to create a new other variable. You can give it any, but I'm giving a DOM code HTML, right? Sorry, code HTML, and just encode that UTF-8, and just pass this variable as a HTML. Just paste that here, right? And just put it semicolon. And also we need to create an object of the dompdf. So just put it any variable, name it here. I'm giving it dompdf and new and dompdf. So this is called object of the dompdf. Just bracket it, right? So here also we need a call some methods of the dompdf class. So first method is load HTML, load underscore HTML, and you need to pass one variable as a code HTML, the semicolon. And also we need mistakes, this underscore, and put it all the small caps HTML. So we need some more methods need to call, just $dompdf, right? And at this time set the orientation. So set the paper is just for A4, A3, right? So just I'm typing the paper size is A4, and its orientation is a landscape. By default it's the portrait mode, right? So I'm just putting it landscape, right? I will remove this when we test, because the by default its orientation is a portrait, and portrait is a good, I like that, right? So according to a report project, we can put this its orientation, right? So if you'd like to add some custom fonts in your PDF content, right? So we can also add some custom fonts, right? So I'll add the font which is courier, right? So dompdf, and call the method which is the set options, or call method which is set underscore option underscore option, and it will take two parameters. The first is the default font, default DEFUL default font, and the other font, font, and the next parameter is take the it takes the font name. So I'm just putting its font name is a courier, but you can put it any font names, so Roboto and Arial and Impact and any custom fonts you can put, but that fonts should be available in your available, right? So next thing, we need to call the generate the PDF. It will render method which will generate your PDF file. So it gives error. So I will set some INI settings. It means set the INI memory limit, right? So just memory limits. I'm just gonna put 128 megabytes, right? So it will not give any error when we generate a PDF files 120 8 megabytes, right? So next thing we need to also call dompdf and start stream. So it will take a one parameter. You can give it any name, but its extension is a PDF, right? You can give it any name. So I'm just putting in voice.pdf, and that's done. So let's refresh, and when we click download as a PDF, and that's dummy content will be in a your PDF file. So this is not HTML. This is a PDF file, right? So let's put some templates inside this variable. So let's right. So this is invoice.pdf file, and this these are the content inside the PDF. So here we will put our template of our invoice, right? If you have any template in HTML, you can copy and paste, right? So I'll show you. I've already designed this template. Just right click view the paste source, and let's copy and paste that code, all the fonts, and this data you can assume that data may also coming from a database, right? I will show you that also in the next video, but don't worry about that. Here is the simplest way to understand dompdf. Just replace a double quotation, so it will not give you an error. So it's good. Now save, right? And let's come back. Let's close it, and let's close it this one, and just refresh, and just download the PDF again, and it will generate invoice.pdf, and let's see. So this is a landscape board, and it has a background CCC, right? Brown color background, right? So we need to fix a little bit. So when you connect it to your database, and this data bill to place of supply, supplier takes invoice rate and date and taxable value and amount. Just assume this data is coming from a database, right? Yeah, it's the simplest way. You just need to connect to your database and write a query, and the data you need to put, paste all the data and put the data inside it here, right? So let's run it again and just generate your PDF invoice.pdf, and at this time it's perfect, right? So we need to do some more things to make its portrait, right? So just scroll down rate date, right? Just I'm showing you this data. May assume that it's coming from a database, right? It's simple. You need to do to yourself. So there's two links, right? So when you check your PDF, right, this is a PDF files and download as a PDF, and there are the two links. So we need to remove these two links from here, right? So because this dummy files is also coming in a PDF, which we don't want to do, right? So this is at this time, there's two links is not there, right? And this is a landscape landscape mode, so just comment it, because by default it's a portrait mode. So just refresh and generate it again. So at this time it will be in a portrait mode. I like the portrait mode. So it's a pretty simple to generate the PDF using a DOM PDF, right? Okay, so we have a done. How we can convert any HTML to an PDF, right? So I want to show you some more thing inside it here, so you can easily remember that in the future as well. So whatever you will type inside this variable, that will be in a PDF, right? Format, any design, any content, and any data from a database, so that will be in a PDF file. So I'm designing as a invoice format, so it will showing me like this, right? So let's close it, and now we will do for the excel.php, but this file is now empty. It's nothing showing any data, right? So we need to do so let's excel.php, this is a file. We need to set some header, right? So let's header and pass some parameters as content and minus type content type dype, and content type is a application and MS Excel, right? So application dot vp vdn / and vnd dot ms dot excel minus excel. So we have set the header, and one more header we need to put, so it will completely work as a Excel, and whatever you will type inside this file will be in a Excel format. So content minus disposition disposition and colon and attachment, and I will give you a file name of your Excel format, XLS file. So you can put it file name or and file name, and I am giving it also in wise.xls. It's file name should be any, but XLS is the important extension, right? And this close, right? And here we will write a HTML to generate the same format which we have inside invoice, right? So let's copy this HTML and paste here in a excel.php. so this data is automatically generated in Excel format, right? So let's remove these two links here. Let's remove, because there's we don't need to these two files in Excel format, right? So let's refresh and let's click. So it's having a problem because excel.php, the same files, it's a download for us, but we want XLS file. So let's check what is the problem inside a file. So content type application bnd dot ms excel. So in this line we don't have any error, ms excel, right, in semicolon, and the content disposition. But if we have a problem in a disposition, we don't put a I because it has a spelling error. And let's save and let's refresh and just click. So it's showing nice, right? So invoice.xls and yes, and you can see, right? But we need to change some formats and some fonts and some font colors. So let's remove the background color and save and just refresh. You can see invoice.xls, and you can see yes, and now you can see the same thing and same data inside the Excel format. So that's good for us. So today we have seen download as a PDF and export as Excel sheet using dompdf, right, using this PHP library which is a dompdf. If you have any questions, send out, please write a comment and let me know what you think about me, right? So bye, take care, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye.